It's the time of year when weather experts like Jesse and Pete send people like me into delightful waterlogged situations like this.
Certainly miserable out here right now, that's obvious.
But the science that got us to Burleson that night safely can do the same for you too. We were navigating by radar that looked like this, a telltale hook that can tell you a tornado could be forming. But in the broad daylight, what can you look for? A wall cloud that looks exactly as its name implies.
Now, not all wall clouds rotate, but the ones that we're going to be really concerned about, they rotate, and they rotate quickly.
When we have a wall cloud, that's step one in the process. Step two is a rotating wall cloud. Step three would be a funnel cloud. Then step four would be a tornado.
We talk about this every year at this time because that's when we're most at risk. Cold air of winter colliding with the warm air of summer. Texas, on average, has 132 tornadoes a year. The busiest months for Texas tornadoes are April, May, and June.
That collision of those air masses, in elementary terms, is exactly what causes these severe thunderstorms.
We're giving people a reminder right now because we're at the start of, historically, the most active part of our severe weather season of the year.
Another reminder, warning sirens like the 168 in the city of Dallas aren't just for tornadoes. Severe thunderstorm warnings over 70 miles an hour and the threat of hail over an inch and a half can cause them to be activated too. But if a tornado is on the way, what can you do? If you can't shelter, can't get underground, which is generally the best advice, remember that where we live, tornadoes generally travel to the east.
Drive away from it if you can, and don't be afraid to do that.
I would go south, and then I would head, you know, off to the west. I would try to stay beneath it, and then get out underneath it, and then head behind it.
And the most important months to pay attention to this advice are right now. In Dallas, I'm Kevin Reese.